Hi folks, it's Kim from Eclectic Papery here today with a product comparison. I'm going to be looking at two similar products, Wendy Vecchi embossing paste and the new Ranger texture paste. I've had a few customers ask me questions about the difference between them, and so I thought I would put together a quick video just to demonstrate what these products do. Okay? So I have a few pieces of paper here. I am using the Strathmore Mixed Media cardstock. It's nice, heavy cardstock. And I've got my embossing paste and a stencil. This is the new Wendy Vecchi stencil. This is the Ornate Dots Overlay. And I am going to pick up some paste here and apply it to the stencil. Putting a relatively thin layer. We'll pick that up. Even have a lovely little bit of blue in there coming off of my... can tell I've used this stencil already. It looks well loved. And then now we're going to do the texture paste. So I will mention that when you open them up, they look very similar. I think that the embossing paste is a little lighter, feels a little fluffier, if that makes sense. I can use some baking type analogies. The embossing paste reminds me of a kind of a buttercream frosting. It's very fluffy, very light. The texture paste seems thicker, a little heavier. When you put them on, they both look the same. The texture paste actually seems sticky. I wouldn't say it necessarily feels that way, but on the knife, it has a feeling of almost a thick glue. That's what it reminds me of. It reminds me of thickened Elmer's glue. When you feel it with the knife, that is what it reminded me of the first time that I use it. I also noticed that when it dries, and I've had this happen a number of times, it seems slightly, and it's slightly flatter, kind of tighter against the cardstock, where I think that the embossing paste holds the volume a little bit better and it's a little bit higher, you know, a little bit thicker. It may be my application of the paste, but that was my observation in using this. I made quite a few samples, and I seem to find that again and again. And I'll show you, I'll try to demonstrate, or it's hard to see it. It's very minor. It's almost more when you rub your hand across it. This feels almost flat. And this, you can actually feel the individual circles as you run your hand across. That was the only difference that I've really noticed. As you can see here, they look identical when you put them down on the piece of paper. There is slightly more in Wendy's jar. Wendy's is 4 ounces. The Ranger is 3.9. So a little bit of a difference there. You'll get a little bit more in the embossing paste than you will the texture paste. And let's see how they take color. Of course, the wonderful thing about the embossing paste is that you can color it with inks. I'll show you that real quick if you haven't seen this before. I can use a distress ink and put down a little bit of the embossing paste and just mix that in. I can do the same thing with archival inks. So this way you can create custom colors with the embossing paste. And of course, Wendy has the mix and store jars, which she's done a ton of research on those and to find the right jar that will not allow the paste to become hardened at all. And so the jar that she has, the mix and store jars, it will stay fresh up to and maybe even beyond two years. That's their from the manufacturer. And she tested a ton of jars before she picked the one that she has. And this is a really nice product. So you can create these custom colors. Love that teal. That's using the an alcohol ink, re-inker. So you can create these custom colors, and then you can store them in your mix and store jars. So you can have all kinds of colors. Love the white. I use the white for everything because you can mix it in everything and create all the colors, and then you can paint and everything over it. So now you're saying, do I have mix and store jars? No, of course not. Why would I think about bringing them home from the store and keeping them in my studio? I don't. So get the mix in store jars so you don't have to throw out paste like that. That's not a good thing. Okay, how about adding color? So I have two samples that are already dry. I will also share that they dry at about the same rate. Using, you know, similar amount down, they were both dry in the same amount of time. So I'm going to put my stencil back down over my dry paste, and I'm going to use Distress ink. You can also use alcohol inks to cover as well. Alcohol inks, of course, you have to kind of press down a little bit more to get the coverage because it doesn't have quite the same, doesn't spread quite as smoothly as Distress inks, but it works awesome. I use the alcohol inks frequently for blending and adding color. All right. So you can see that has completely covered the white. Of course, not on the spot that I didn't go over, but anywhere that I put the ink down, we have complete and full coverage on the color. So that's on the embossing paste. And again, here's the texture paste. You'll have to see it, I guess, yourself, but it's dried and it's flatter. That's all I can say. I don't know. And that would just be personal preference. I like a little bit more dimension. But that's the one thing I've noticed again and again. All right. So I find that taking color, it's the same. You can see we have good full coverage on the texture paste as well. So both of them take color exactly the same. One is not better than the other. I'll show you the rest of my samples too. These are, this was archival ink on the top and again, distress ink on the bottom. So you can see that they both took the color fine. The embossing paste, you know, I did the exactly the same on both. You can, this is putting the colored paste through a stencil, just so you can see what that looks like. So those both are, you know, this is the white using a distress ink to color the paste. You can also color the paste with ink sprays. So this was paste on top of an acrylic painted background and then a Delusions ink spray on top. And you can see they both take the ink fine, the spray. And then I also used acrylic paints. And I do color my paste frequently with acrylic paint as well. You can use distress paints. You can use, this was one of those little Adirondack paint daubers. You can use the new Paper Artsy paints, any kind of acrylics you can mix in with your paste. So here's where I noticed this little bit of a change in the texture once it's dry, or in the depth, I suppose. And of course, the texture paste, you could just put another layer on and then it would, you know, come up a little bit higher. But you can see here when I ran the dauber across the embossing paste that the paint did not soak down all the way around all of the dots, where on the texture paste, you know, just going over it with the dauber colored the entire background. So that's just my personal observation. The other thing is that both of these products have flexibility. The embossing paste is not going to flake or crack. I have been using embossing paste since it came on the market. I think it's been about a year and a half. I use it frequently in my art journals, and one of the pages I wanted to show you from about a year ago, the entire background of the piece was covered with embossing paste. So this is all embossing paste through a large 12 by 12 stencil. So, and then covered with acrylics, and you can see I'm able to bend it and move it. It's been a year. There's all kinds of dimensional stuff in my journal. Actually, my remnant rubs are coming up a little bit. I've got to work on that. But the paste is not flaking or cracking or anything else is going on there. So it's held up fine. It's been, you know, a year since this page was created. So in conclusion, I think we have products that are pretty similar. You get a little bit more with Wendy's. I think that they behave the same when ink is applied to them. They both take color fine. So hope that's helpful for you. If you have the Wendy Vecchi embossing paste, I don't think you need to pick up another product. That's going to kind of do the same thing as what you already have in your stash. All right. So I hope that helps, and happy crafting. Take care.